Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. I have two friends with me today, Rachel C. and my good friend the sea bass. Well, he's actually going to be my meal later on, but he has an important purpose. Now, the sea bass and Rachel, they may look pretty different to you, but believe it or not, they have a lot in common. It's their inside parts that, believe it or not, are pretty similar. Scientists call these inside parts organs, and each organ is made of the same type of cell, and each organ also does a very special job for the body. Now remember, plants and animals are all made of cells, and those cells need two things. They need oxygen from the air or the water, and they need food. Rachel's lungs take oxygen from the air and put it into the blood. Rachel's stomach and intestines takes food that she eats and puts that into the blood, and the heart is the thing that moves that blood all throughout the body to all those cells. Well, what about the sea bass? Let's zoom in and take a closer look at his organs and see what they do. Now remember, this entire sea bass is made of cells. This part right here is muscle, and that muscle is made of muscle cell. In fact, most of the fish is muscle. So the question is, how do all those muscle cells get food and oxygen? Well, to answer that, we need to look at its organs. So let's pull the skin back so I can show you the first organ right here. These are called the gills, and they actually take oxygen out of the water and put it into the blood. So how does the fish then get the oxygen in the blood to all the other cells? Well, I'm going to show you this tiny white thing right here at the end of my pointer. That's actually the fish's heart. This red thing is the liver. This tiny white thing is the two-chamber heart, and it pumps the blood to all the other cells. So we took care of how the oxygen gets to all the cells, but how does the food get to all the cells? Well, the fish will take food in through his mouth, and that food will go into his stomach, and all this right here, well, that's his intestines. The food gets broken down in the stomach and the intestines, and then gets passed to the blood. Then the heart pumps that blood to all the cells in the body. And just like us, any food that the fish can't use comes out the other end. We want to take a closer look at one more special organ that only fish have. Now, scientists call that an adaptation. Anytime animals have a special organ, scientists call that an adaptation. Fish live in the water, and they need a special organ to help them stay balanced and move easily in the water. And that special organ that only fish have is called the swim bladder because it helps them swim a whole lot better. So now we're going to zoom in and show you the swim bladder. We're going to show you where it is and what it does. The swim bladder is this stretchy bag of skin right above the stomach and intestines, and it's usually filled with a gas, which is oxygen. Watch what happens when I fill it with air, with my straw. The bag stretches out as the air fills it, and that helps the fish swim more easily and stay balanced in the water. That's a pretty cool adaptation. It's really amazing if you think about it. Rachel and the sea bass look so different on the outside, but when you compare their inside parts, well, a lot of them do the same thing. They take air and oxygen and move that to all of the cells. But it's also amazing to think how Rachel and the sea bass are different. Fish live in the water, and they have a streamlined body to help move through the water, and they have gills to get oxygen out of the water, and they have the all-important swim bladder. If you want to learn more about how the parts of living things work, check out our links in the video description. Science is so cool. The body is so cool. Thanks for watching.